Hello, I am Maria Rastor from the University of Alicante. I am going to present the work I have co-authored with my supervisor David Ballester. It is entitled, as you can see, Time Series of Sentinel-1 Backscattering Data from Oil Palm Plantations. First of all, I will describe the motivation and the purpose of our investigation. There are more and more industrial oil palm plantations, and it has a major social and environmental impact on tropical forest ecosystems. As known, radar remote sensing becomes a useful tool to monitor tropical deforestation. We have studied the backscattering sensitivity of Sentinel-1 data with respect to oil palm crops, being the final objective discrimination between tropical forests and oil palm plantations. To this aim, we have employed 7 images covering from year 2015 to 2021. To begin with, I will discuss the area we've focused on our research. As you can see, our study area is located in the African continent, exactly in the country of Gabon, indicated with a red rectangle. On the right picture, a radar image is shown. For our study, we have considered 7 polygons corresponding to tropical forest, oil palm plantation, and a small savanna area, as displayed on this slide. On this slide, we can see the reference map used to carry out our research. This image has been provided by Mighty Air Environmental Organization. Here, we detail the sensor probes employed on audit from the Alaska Satellite Facility Data Portal. As you can see, all the files have been obtained between February and April, so our analysis is focused in the wet season. All the preprocessing steps have been performed by using a SNAP software, as you can see. For each polygon, we have obtained the histogram and the corresponding mean, standard deviation, and coefficient of variation values. After the histogram analysis, backscattering time series have been obtained from 2015 to 2021, with an image per year for both VH and VV channels. In addition, the ratio between VV and VH has been also investigated. The backscattering time series of forest and oil palm for all polygons are plotted together with the savanna time series. As we can see, in the case of forest, for both VH and VV backscattering, pretty constant levels are maintained through the period. However, the values for 2015 and 2021 show a slight noticeable variability, possibly due to variations in environmental conditions. Savanna is showing red color, and you see that it can be distinguished from both forest and oil palm for almost the whole period. The oil palm backscattering exhibits the greatest variability over time. For VH, in 2015, we can see the values for the 3 polygons are about -16, -15 dBs, which leads us to affirm that it's completely bare area. Then it increases until 2018, where it reaches saturations that led to it decreasing following years. For VV, we can see it also increases up to saturation point in 2019, but nevertheless, the backscattering remains more stable once this point is reached. It exhibits higher backscattering values than in forest areas. Once the VH and VV channels time series have been analyzed, we have calculated the power ratio between VV and VH to see how these different trends are combining into a single radar signature. For the forest areas, the ratio between VV and VH remains fairly stable between values 4 and 5. However, for the oil palm areas 1 and 3, there appear a clear increase being the ratio in the interval 6-7 for the last image. Note, however, that for the polygon 2, the behavior is different as there is a slow decrease. A possible explanation is a delayed plantation within that particular area. Finally, the conclusions obtained from this work are as follows. We have been able to analyze the time series backscattering series for the Sentinel-1 of oil palm plantation from the initial stage of growth, it is to say, for 6 years. We focus on the possible discrimination between oil palm plantations and tropical forests. We have seen that the conclusions on the VH and VV backscattering we have obtained are in accordance with previous works done with Envisat and Sentinel-1 in case of oil palms exhibit some growth. Finally, the use of ratio between VV and VH has been shown to have the potential to discriminate between oil palms and natural forests. For future work, it will be interesting to design or use an electromagnetic model of oil palms at Sivan, and also to study the behavior of time series and ratios for the dry season, from late June to the end of August. And this is all. Thank you for your attention.